Hello students, so far we have been seeing the unit 2 of your textbook titled as Wit and Humor. Now we all are referring to unit 3rd which is titled as the Human Relation. Okay, under the title Human Relations we again will be seeing different chapters. So today, in today's chapter which is the journey, we will be talking about the author's experience while their journey, author's experience with his father, okay, along the journey from home to the bus stop. Okay, so this journey lesson is the author's experience with his father along the journey from his home to the bus stop. Okay, so this lesson is all about how the author felt, what was his experience when he was traveling to the bus stop from his home along with his father. So before entering into the topic, we need to understand more details about the author. So let us proceed with the scene. So the name of the author is Yeshe Dorji Tongchi. So the name of the author is Yeshe Dorji Tongchi. He was born in the year of 1952. Okay, and he is the famous personality in Assamese and English literature. He actually came from a very very poor background, but still he could manage to top himself in the in his studies, in his academics, and he joined as a member of Arunachal Pradesh State Public Services. And then because of his devotion to his work, because of his ground-earth attitude, he was again promoted to Indian Administrative Services. So he was so skilled within administration sector. Okay, and then later on he was also interested in the field of literature. Okay, his best novel was titled as Mauna Ont Mukhar Hriday, and we also have Sona. So this Mauna Ont Mukhar Hriday, written in Assamese language, was selected for the award at the national level. Okay, so this is how, these are various achievements of Yeshe Dorji Tongchi in the field of literature and in his own administrative career. So this lesson, The Journey, is actually written in Assamese language and it is translated to English by D.P. Nath. So Mr. D.P. Nath has presented this lesson in English to us. Let us proceed to the lesson now. So the journey. In our lives also, we generally tend to have journeys so many times. Every journey gives us its own experience. Every journey gives us its own essence. Okay, there are certain journeys which we never forget in our life. So here, let us see what was the thing which made author remember this journey with his father to a time so long. Okay, so in the opening, actually the author is, or the character in this story, let us take it as author. So the author is an officer, grade 1 officer working in the hilly areas of Arunachal Pradesh, and he happened to come to his home after a long time from his office, taking leave from his office, he has come to his home. So in this lesson, let us see how the journey is so important to the author. What experience has made author to remember this journey for a long time, and how and why is this lesson being given to you people? What moral values can be extracted from this lesson? Okay, so the lesson starts like the author turns up from his office to his home, taking a long leave. Okay, and then as he is a grade 1 officer, he is a central officer, he gets leave and he comes home and he takes rest in his home. Okay, and then the main purpose of he coming to his home is to, as his parents have set up a marriage for him, he comes for the same. Okay, while coming he does not carry much of the luggage because he is coming for the purpose of marriage, so everything will be arranged by his family members. And then once he comes to his home after marriage, he feels free because he is there almost for 5 months. He would be there in the village taking rest. And now the time comes that he has to leave his house after a period of 5 months. Okay, and after getting leave for 5 months, he becomes lethargic. Not only he, it's a human tendency. Once we stop working, we don't want to continue it ahead. Because that laziness, lethargicness, the tendency, what is lethargicness here? The tendency of a human, to stop ourselves from doing or prolonging with the work. So even here the author becomes so lethargic and doesn't want to go and continue with his with his job. And then he thinks of let me extend my leave again. No problem. Till then for 5 months he get paid leave. Okay, the government is ready to pay him. Now he thinks that it's better I will again extend my leave. Though it is unpaid, no problem. Let me extend it and all. What is the main cause here? As he is newly married, he doesn't want to leave his wife at that place and go. Okay, and it's a normal tendency when we are in relationship, it is really difficult for us. It may happen most of the times with you people also, when you go in summer vacations to your cousins, to your grandparents, okay, you don't feel like leaving them and coming back. So here the same feel the author gets, okay, but then he feels responsible. Then he remembers his responsibility that as I got married, I have to take care of my family members. I have added one new member, one newcomer to my family, my wife. I have to take her responsibility. If I don't earn money, this is not the way I have to behave, that I will just extend my holidays and will stay back at home. I need to be responsible enough. I can't give this burden to my parents who have already struggled a lot to give me education, to make me what I am today. Okay, so then the author decides that no, this is wrong decision which I am taking, that I'll extend my leave. I should not extend my leave, but rather I should go. I should work. I should get the money. And whatever debts my father has made for my marriage, I have to clear all these debts along. Okay, so this is what the author feels. And then he decides to move to his office after a period of 5 months. Okay, and then as usual, when he decides that he has to travel to his office, he packs his bag. And as you all know, he has come to his home. So he doesn't have to carry, he did not bring much luggage along with him. But while going, at least he has to carry a pair of clothes and pair of boots and all whatever is required for him to wear in the office. So he does the same thing. He packs a small trunk. Trunk is nothing but children, the suitcase like thing which is made up of iron. Okay. So in the olden days, people used to carry this trunk on their heads, okay, whenever they used to go from one place to other place. But nowadays, as the modern era has come, we have started using plastic suitcases and other stuff. So as you all know that we are discussing about author's journey now. So author packs a iron trunk of all his accessories, whatever he requires for his office. Now the thing is, he has to start for his journey, right? So when he wants to start for his journey, the problem is the place where the author lives is a hilly area. Okay, it's not a metro city, it's a village in a hilly area. And it does not have motored roads. Motored roads in the sense, the roads which are made up of cement and tar and all these things. It is, road, uneven road covered with all the mud and stuff and all the pebbles and all, okay. So, an author, there is no provision for any vehicles to come up, and then the author have to just walk so far to reach to his bus bay. Okay. And the buses do not directly come to his villages where he stay. He has to go to a place known as Dirham, and there from that bus stop, he'll be going to his own office. Then, what has happened now, when he came to his home from the village 5 months ago, that time his trunk, means that briefcase or maybe his luggage was carried by a porter, porter coolie, right? The one who carries all the stuff. So the porter carried that trunk from his home, from the bus stop to his home. So he did not face much of the problem. But what has happened later is, while going, almost all the villagers were busy in the field because that was cultivating season. And nobody would take out time for, just leaving all the work aside and just carrying his brief trunk to the bus stop, because bus stop was so many kilometers far and he has to walk. So that was not very easy for him. Then what he has done, he was thinking like, now who has to carry my trunk? I am an officer. I cannot carry my trunk on my head and walk. That will be really cheap. People will look at me and they'll laugh. Okay, so I cannot, I know it's not good that I gave my responsibility to others, but this will not be good. My parents may not feel happy. My neighbors may not feel happy if I carry this. This will spoil my dignity. Okay, this is how the author was thinking, and he was little tensed about that. And then suddenly his father comes. His father comes and sees author in tension and then asks him, "What happened, son?" And then the son is speechless because he directly cannot say, right? He values his father. He directly cannot say to his father that, "Father, I can't carry my trunk on my head, so I want somebody to carry it," right? So he doesn't say that to his father, but his father is, you know, a mature person. He could make out what the need of his son is. And then he says, "Don't worry, son. I know there is nobody to catch your trunk. I will take it to the bus stop. Don't worry about it." Actually, author sensibly feels bad within himself that how can I ask my father to carry my trunk? I should be responsible enough. I should carry my own trunk. But I'm sorry that I'm not able to carry, because if I carry, my father may feel hurt for the sake. And then he decides to leave. Okay. And then when he is about to leave, so many villagers come to meet him. Okay. To, you know, give him send off, because he is almost the person who is the only educated probably in that village. So everybody respects his family and him a lot, and they all come to bid him farewell. And then after they meet him, meanwhile his father already started his journey, and he keeps the trunk on his shoulders and father is moving. And then he meets everybody in the village and all, and then he bids bye to everyone, carrying one water bottle and one small bag in his hand, and he rushes very 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 fast to follow, to, you know, accompany his father, who's already left a long time ago. And then while walking, the author thinks that it's waste. How waste I am. I should carry my own luggage, but I have given it to my father to carry. Is it a fair thing what I have done? Though I am educated, my physical strength is of no use. I am a shun labor, I am useless. Okay, so he feels like that. Then again he feels that, but if I carry that trunk on my head, all the villagers will say he is a great officer, he has a white collar job. White collar job is something which is used in the political definition. So he has got a white collar job, and how will he be carrying that trunk on his head? My father may not feel good, okay, because villagers may laugh at him. So maybe my father is comfortable carrying, okay, let me accompany. So he just, you know, satisfies himself with the same thing, and he accompanies his father. And he runs, and then he reaches to his father. And then finally father says, like, "Son, are you tired? You look tired." Then the son says, "Yes, father, I have crossed two hills so fast to meet you, because you were walking very fast. So let us take rest somewhere." And then the author and his father sits under a tree. And then father looks at the son and he smiles. Okay. And the son says, and the father asks to his son that, "Are you really tired?" Then son says, "Yes, I don't have any more stamina to walk." But then the father says that, "But we don't have any other option. We have to walk, because you have to board your bus. If you will not walk, then your bus may be missed. Okay, so we have to walk." And then father, you know, as he carried a lot of luggage on his head, he feels thirsty, and then his eyes are on the bottle which is carried by author. So it contains some wine. And then the father asks the son, the author, to give him a mug of wine, and he have it and then give the remaining to his son. And then both of them again stand up and again they walk towards their destination, that is to the bus stop. Again in between they stop near a hotel, and then they have some snacks and all, and again they start their journey. So all the while the journey, the father and the author, they doesn't talk to each other. They are walking as if they both are strangers. They don't have anything to speak, or as if they don't know each other's language. That way they walk. Finally they reach to bus stop, and there they observe that still the bus has not arrived. And then they sit aside, and then they are talking. While talking, author's father asks him that, "Do you have an old pair of shoe?" And then author is like in a dilemma. My father doesn't wear shoe, but now why is he asking for the same? And then the author asks to his father, "Father, why do you need shoe?" And then the father says, "I have been walking carrying that bag so long. It is okay for me. Carrying a heavy luggage is not a big matter. But that road is full of pebbles, full of uncertainties. I was not able to walk and my bare feet, it hurts a lot when I'm walking all through that way. And then the author observed his father's feet. And he have seen that his feet were totally developed with cracks. And then he could empathize with his father's pain, what he has actually suffered while walking barefooted in the road which was full of pebbles, soil, mud and all these uncertainties. Okay? And then he thinks how my father actually managed to carry such a heavy trunk on his shoulders and walked all the way like this. Then he checks his wallet, and when he checks his wallet, he finds rupees 40 in his wallet. Okay? And after finding rupees 40 in his wallet, he calculates in his mind that if I take a pair of normal shoes for my father, canvas shoes, then it would cost me just 12 rupees. So let me buy a new pair of shoe. And then he takes out money and gives it to his father and tells him that, father, you can buy a new pair of shoe. And father then says, no son, I don't want a new pair of shoe. If you have any old one, you please give me, or else it's fine, I will manage to walk like this. And then the son feels that I'm so careless that I could even not convince my father to buy a new shoes, whereas he gave me lot of education, he supported me lot in each and every aspect. Today what I am is all because of his efforts. Maybe my father practically would have gone through so many uncertainties and struggles to make me what I am today. So then our author does is, whatever leather shoe he is wearing, the boots, he takes off those boots and gives it to his father and says, father, you please wear these boots for me. I will wear another pair of leather shoes in my trunk. And then he opens his trunk, takes the leather shoe and wears it. And that boots he gives to his father to wear. And his father wears those boots. And within that meanwhile, the bus reaches to the station. And then the son gets into the bus along with his luggage and sits near the window, the allotted seat. And then he waves bye to his father. His father actually gives a gesture as if he wants to say something to his son. But as you know, it happens most of the time. And while we want to converse, the vehicles start leaving. Here also the same thing happens. When father wants to speak something with his son, the bus starts leaving. And father and son wave bye to each other. And the son feels like, you know, see how unlucky I am. Actually, my father struggled to give me education. My father struggled for my future. And today I am sitting on a luxurious seat and going in the vehicle. Whereas to reach home, my father again had to travel the roads on two or three hills he has to pass and reach home. So where am I giving, you know, comfort to my father? This is how the author feels very, very bad, very sad within himself. But again, he thinks that, no, when my father wanted me to become an officer, I have become an officer. So after becoming officer, all the villagers started respecting my father. All the villagers started respecting my family. So somewhere my father is really happy. Because he is happy, he comfortably carried the trunk today. Means somewhere, when I fulfilled the dream of my father, I have become a capable son in front of him. This is how the author convinced himself, and then he waves bye to his father. Author moves in one direction towards his office and father moves back towards his home. So children, what do we learn in this lesson? What is the moral of this lesson? This lesson says that if we are grounded, if we follow the decisions of our parents, definitely at some or the other point of life, we will be reaching pinnacle of success. And not only we alone, but at each and every step, our parents will be supporting us in good deeds. But if we take or make the wrong decisions in our life, then definitely we will miss out the support of our parents. So children, whenever you take right decision for yourself, please sit with your parents, discuss all the issues with them. Okay, you are matured enough, they are matured enough, definitely they will think something good for you. As author's father helped to carry a heavy bag on his back, maybe your parents will also support you carrying something for you. May not be in literal manner, but they will guide you, they will give you good suggestions which you can follow in your life and make your life the best one. So hoping that you also have a wonderful journey with your parents all the while, and some or the other day, even I get the privilege to read your own journey with your parents. Hope that you have understood the lesson well. Thank you one and thank you all.